In this session, we will discuss public key cryptography. Before knowing about public key cryptography, first we will discuss what is the problem of symmetric key cryptography. Symmetric key cryptography means only one key is used for both encryption and decryption. For example, sender performs some encryption operation by using some key. After performing encryption operation, the encrypted message along with the key is to be passed to the receiver, because both sender and receiver interacts with only one key. Sender performs encryption using this key, receiver decrypts the message by using this key only. During this transformation, there is a chance for attacking of the key. Whenever an attacker hacks the key, simply he decrypts the message and unauthorized message is sent to the receiver. So that is the main problem of symmetric key cryptography. Simply one key is used for both encryption and decryption. Now, to overcome this problem, we are moving to some another technique, that is simply asymmetric key cryptography or public key cryptography. So in symmetric, the main problem is only one key is used for both encryption and decryption. Here we are using two keys. One key is used for encryption and some other key is used for decryption. That is, sender performs encrypted operation using one key. Receiver performs decryption operation using some another key. Simply in public key cryptography, the elements are plain text. That is, this cryptography, what are the elements we have to consider? Plain text, encryption algorithm, pub keys, decryption algorithm, ciphertext. So plain text is the original message that we want to send. Simply, this is an input to the algorithm. That is, the sender wants to send some message. That some message is called plain text. Encryption algorithm, the plain text is converted into some unreadable format and that format is sent to the receiver. So encryption algorithm converts the plain text into some unreadable format. That is encryption algorithm. Keys, here the keys specifies to perform encryption algorithm we are using some key. Generally in asymmetric key cryptography, that is public key cryptography, keys are divided into two types. One is public key, second one is private key. One is public key, second one is private key. To perform either encryption operation or decryption operation, we are using these two keys. Decryption algorithm means whenever sender sends the message to the receiver decrypts the message into readable format. And ciphertext means simply the unreadable message. So here plain text means input to the algorithm, ciphertext means output to the algorithm. To convert plain text into ciphertext, we are using some encryption algorithm. To convert ciphertext into plain text, we are performing some decryption algorithm. To perform either encryption algorithm or decryption algorithm, we are using keys. Here in this asymmetric, we are using public key and private key. Now we will discuss public key and private key. The procedure for sending messages to the receiver are, first, both sender and receiver generates a pair of keys. Suppose if a sender wants to send some message to receiver B, both sender and receiver generates a pair of keys. So pair means two keys. In the pair of keys, one key is placed in public register. Among these two keys, One key is placed in public register. That means the key access public key. And one key is kept as private. One key is kept as secret. That key is called private key. That key is called private key. That is, each user generates a pair of key. One key is placed in public register. That means that key is visible to all other users in a system. And one key is kept as secret. That is visible to only the user who generates the key. In the key placed in public register is called public key. The key what we are kept as secret is called private key. Once these two keys are generated, we are performing encryption and decryption operation. For example, user A wants to send some message. First it perform some encryption operation. Suppose if the message is X. To perform this encryption algorithm, we are using some key. For example, if we are using the public key of B. Suppose user A wants to send some message to user B. We have two types of encryptions and decryptions. The first one is user A performs encryption using public key of B, because public key of each user is known by everyone. After performing encryption, suppose if the message is Y, now this message is transferred to user B. Decryption algorithm. At decryption algorithm, we are providing decryption using private key of B, and it produces the final text X. So I will explain the procedure. Here in this example, first the message is encrypted by using public key of B. For example, this is key source generator at B side. So the public key is visible to each and every user. So by using B public key, a user A performs encryption. Now the encrypted message is transferred into receiver. Here B only knows the private key. That is, the Y is received by many number of users. Only the actual recipient only decrypts the message, because PRB is the private key. In a similar fashion, we are moving to one more type of encryption. Suppose the message is encrypted by using some encryption algorithm. In this step, suppose we are encrypted by using private key of A. Here source is A and destination is B. Encrypt the message using private key of A. Whenever we transfer the message, it decrypt the message by using public key of A. Suppose this is some key source at A side. So these are the two possibilities of encryption and decryption. By observing these two figures, to perform both encryption and decryption, we are using only one pair of keys of a single user. In this case, we are using only user B's keys. Suppose user A wants to send some message to user B. If you want to use user B keys, at encryption we are applying only public key. At decryption, we are applying private key. Similarly, suppose user A wants to send some message to user B. At encryption, user A applies his private key. User A applies his private key and perform encryption. User B applies the public key of A to perform decryption. Simply, this procedure is called authentication. this procedure is called authentication. Authentication means simply these two are connected. User A and user B are some connected. That is, one is authorized person of another. So here B only knows. Here B only knows that the message is encrypted. All other recipients, that is all other users in the system, doesn't know whether the message is encrypted or not encrypted. These two are two types of encryptions. One, in both the cases we are using only a single pair of key. Suppose if you want to perform confidentiality, if you want to perform confidentiality, perform two encryptions at source side and two decryptions at destination side. So now we will discuss confidentiality. Suppose this is the message. The message X is performed encryption. Again, suppose it produces Y. Again, perform encryption. Suppose it produces message Z. After first performing encryption, it produces Y. After second performing, it produces Z. Now the Z is transferred to the receiver. Suppose at the receiver, first decryption. First Z is decrypted, it converted into Y. Next Y is decrypted, it converted into X. So we are receiving the message. For example, this is user A, this is user B. User A, user B, key source. Yet user A side, key source at B side. Key source at user A side and key source at B side. Suppose with the first encryption, if you are encrypted, suppose by using private key of A. Suppose at the first two encryption, if you are encrypt the message using private key of A, and its second encryption we are using public key of B. That is, simply I am combining the previous two approaches. Key source of A, key source of B, it will generate PRA, private key of A, and PUA, public key of A. Similarly, PUB and PRB. First, to encrypt the message using private key of A. And the encrypted message is again encrypted using public key of B. It produces Z. Now, this Z is decrypted. This Z is decrypted by using private key of B. By using private key of B. And this one is decrypted by public key of A. So in each encryption and decryption we are using similar pair. So this is confidentiality. These are the public key cryptography introduction. Thank you.